Are you fucking kidding me? Right?
Yeah.
Our sorority's having a kegger and we'd love for you to come.
Okay.
Oh my god, that's so cool. Tonight, Kappa Phi. Oh, it's gonna be such a blast.
Sure.
Oh, great! See you there. Bye!
Van Halen is my favorite band. Dave, of course. And I love cartoons. Flintstones are my favorite. But my all-time favorite thing, I have to say, is to stay home and watch anything with my favorite actor, Bronson Pinchot.
Bronson Pinchot?
Oh my God, you like Bronson Pinchot?
Oh my God, do I love Bronson Pinchot. Let's have a hot sex right now.
Get out! Why does every 20-year-old woman treat me like a piece of meat?
I'm gonna have sukiyaki here. Bust out a fistful egg for young. All over your ass. How you like that, okay?
Well, as much as I would probably enjoy egg for young on my ass, I think there is a phrase here in America which goes something like money is a louder talker than the screaming. I hope we can come to some sort of understanding.
You can't go in there.
Here you go.
Stedman?
I'll be with the gentleman in a second. Go on, sign it.
Stedman, you're under arrest for fraud. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law.
It's just a little mix-up. Go on, sign it.
Sign it, you white Jezebel!
I'll call Matt!
Nice to meet you, Jack. I'm Nancy. Don't worry about all that treatment stuff. Let's just get you settled in first, okay? Hang out for a sec and I'll give you the grand tour.
What?
You saw him!
No, 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 no!
Ryan, you're
crazy!
Was it crazy?
I didn't do anything.
He was gonna stick his thing inside of me! Inside of my vagina.
Shall I call
my
you?
Vagina.
Shall I call
do
you
me?
Want me to call Dr. Jenny?
No.
Do you
want to
go back upstairs
and
then sit?
Mmm, so good. No.
I'm glad you like it.
Yes. Yes, I'll marry you. Okay. I love you so much.
I love you too, baby.
We were in here earlier having dinner with our friend Sam-I-Am.
You mean Will-I-Am?
Oh, okay.
Is that what you call him? That's weird. I don't like that.
That is weird.
No, listen, anyway, we were here and Will-I-Am thinks he left his phone at the table, so we need to check the table.
I'd like to check the table for the phone, if you don't mind.
Do you understand what I'm saying? Look at me. We need to check the table
problem?
For the phone.
Fine. This way.
Wow. I just wasted half my life.
Hey!
Hi! Tony, don't make me say it, okay?
Well,
I don't want to be that guy.
Don't be Evander the Reprimander. Just
I don't
want to
be, but give me a break, Tony.
No,
this is ridiculous.
Come on, dude. I'm at home. It's control. Just what are you thinking?
Let me get this straight. The military can't have the technology, but you can use it as a party favor with the...
Rebecca! With 1C!
Thank you. Tony, come on.
Come on,
this
dude.
Is ridiculous.
It's one night a year, please. Are you kidding me with this? Please, I got Kojak. I'm having a ball here.
Tony.
Give me a break.
Put the tech away.
What do you want? You want me to stop? I'll shut the tech now. All right? Fly, girl. Shut down your engines. Come down, Papa. Whew.
Thank you.
Okay.
There's something about Star Wars fan films that
to me, I know it sounds really dorky, but it makes me very emotional. When I watch these fans who are so passionate about it, and they've got such a great sense of humor, and I think that Star Wars fan films are so special because they're coming from the fans. There's something, that one little thing that only they would have known, and they turn it into something really great and wonderful, and usually they're funny.
I think you'll see that I've targeted a few industries where I really see the dividends multiplying.
Mm. Yeah. I see.
What is the matter with you? I think you've placed something in my mouth. I have lice.
You have
lice? Oh my God. I couldn't get out of there fast enough. I just kept picturing little tiny bugs propelling off my hair into his inbox.
Oh my God. I'm going to vomit.
When I got the call that they wanted me for this movie, and it was Sarah Jessica Parker, and then it's Greg Kinnear and Pierce Brosnan and Christina Hendricks, I was so excited. I mean, it's everything I've ever wanted. What I loved about this character and her story in the film is that so oftentimes you see the woman falling for the guy and wanting to progress a relationship from 0 to 60. And this was a story where Channing's character is falling in love with my character and wanting more and wanting that companion and wanting her to be in his life. One thing I loved about Joanna more than just, you know, being a symbol for women was that she's a mirror to him and to other people, which is I can only reflect back what you give me, and I'm only giving you how much you give me. And I think sometimes we, as just human beings, we expect people to read our minds or to give more of themselves. And a lot of times women do that. We end up giving so much more and we're not getting anything back.
I'm afraid your sperm count is too low to conceive.
But that is impossible.
Well, I know some men find it difficult to hear that, but...
Hold on a second. I mean, how can we tell that it's not...
Well, I've already examined Audrey.
Her tubes are clear. Her
hormone levels are perfect. And she has, in my opinion, two of the pinkest, plumpest, and most beautiful ovaries I have ever seen.
Thank you.
Are you hitting on my wife?
Tommy.
Is that what he was doing?
No.
It seemed like it was.
I'm sorry about that.
Ryan, easy, 2 years.
Oh my God! We have been together for over 4 years! 4 wonderful years, Dave!
I'm sorry, Madeline. Just cut me some slack, all right? I got a lot going on right now.
You're right, you're so busy. You look tired watching your life spiral downwards. Oh, there it is, there it is. Oh, I'm stepping on it. That's your life, Dave.
You not having a little something to drink?
Oh, no, I never drink alcohol. I don't like to blunt my senses.
How awful.
Well, I feel wonderful.
Ooh.
Feel me.
Oh, yes.
No, not there, stupid. Here.
Ah.
You know what? She should be your plus one for the wedding.
You know what?
You should get in the car.
I need to get somebody for you.
You need to get in the car.
You want to just have an empty plate there for... I'm getting in the car. I'm not going to keep doing this with you. It's so much disrespect. I mean, what's funny to me, James, the plastic gun, I detected that. But you don't say nothing about that, do you?
Professional hitter on a hacker?
Club full of witnesses.
And I'm driving.
No, you're not.
I'm in a driver's seat, James, which means I'm driving.
Give me my keys.
Why does your car smell like burnt toast? Because it stinks.
That's not toast. Ben, get the hell out of the car. Okay. Oh,
get off my neck. Get off of me.
Did you guys get that on camera? We
need that
for HR.
That doesn't mean anything.
We need that for HR. Do you need that light on?
It means nothing.
Get this?
This is how Kevin and Olivia like to mix it up.
Let me pick you up. Come on.
No,
let me. Come on. Lean. Kevin, lean back.
Did I ever tell you the story of Chandler the pig? Actually, we learned it was a she pig, but we'd already named her Chandler. Imagine, three sisters, Arkansas, no TV. My sister Laura, she came in one day with this baby pig that she had stolen from our neighbor, Mr. Lawson. We decided to keep her as a secret pet. The first thing she did was break some of my mother's really nice china. It was mayhem. So we decided to keep her in our room with us, and we fed her with our baby sister's bottle. How gross is that, right? Of course, Mr. Lawson came over one day. I said I knew nothing about it. When all of a sudden, little Chandler just starts moving across the kitchen with a little curly tail. And then in that moment, my sister and I opened the door, and then Chandler just ran like hell. She clearly didn't want any bacon. The wood, right? Split them up. They lube me down, and I step into this latex. We did a whole latex fitting.
Yes.
And I
And then she goes to work. All right. Now we're talking.
Hey, we should pitch this to Data City. I swing for the fences, and I'm going to change the game. Hey, are you okay?
Yeah.
Really? Because you seem a little off today. You seem a little weird.
Well...
Oh my gosh, today is the day, right? Hey, congratulations, you're free. You gonna get a back tattoo and some skinny jeans?
Funds are a little tight, but it feels good to be free.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, thank you for this.
Coco. Oh my gosh, I love it. I'll make your favorite, dumplings. Seeing it just makes it more fun and exciting. Oh, and also don't forget.
Yeah?
It's your birthday, Lloyd. Yay! Have a happy birthday, honey.
Thanks, Mom. I'll try my best.
Of course you will. Are you fucking kidding me?
Look, I know this sounds crazy. I've never felt more purpose than I have these last few weeks. These guys need me, and I need them. And this is gonna keep happening every year for the rest of my life. And you're just gonna end up hating them and resenting me, and who knows, maybe you'll end up shooting me in the balls and taking all my money like shit. Oh!
Whoa! Bobby! Bing!
No, I really respect your choice. And your honesty. I just wish you would have told me 5 fucking years ago that you would have chosen your friends' balls and their farts over me.
Wait for it.
Life all comes down to chance.
Do you get kidnapped?
Yes.
I'd kidnap you.
Oh.
This wedding is over!
Oh my God! You are a piece of...
What are you doing?
Just taking a really strong sedative. Just put your fingers down my throat.
What?
I can't do it myself.
Oh!
Oh!
I just wanted to check to see if you guys were good. You're good? The way I've always been doing things just doesn't work now. I want to be free.
You're a freak. You're fat. Your hair is gross. You're a baby. You smell. Don't be a bitch. Everyone can see you. You should be falling in love.
You play here now?
I guess so.
We should find another table.
I'm worried about Ashley.
You don't need to be. Her dad's back, everything's fine.
I'm also concerned for you.
Well, that's very nice of you.
Mike, you know he's no good for Ashley to be around.
Right, thanks for telling me what my family needs.